Have you ever needed to calculate and plot an isochrone on a map? Probably not, because you've never heard of that word. But if you ever wanted to know where you could go in this many minutes with this much fuel remaining, you just didn't know it had such a cool name. Julie is here to explain what it is and how to calculate an isochrone and plot it with Azure Maps today on Azure Friday. Hey friends, I'm Scott Hanselman, and it's another episode of Azure Friday. I'm here with Julie Kohler, who's going to talk to me about isochrones, my new word of the day. I'm very excited about this word. What does it mean, and why do I need it?
Another term could be considered reachable range.
Reachable range. See, immediately I know what that means.
Yeah, so when you start at an origin or a point, all of the places that you can get within a certain 10 minutes or I have a certain amount of fuel, so it's really the shape that's created from starting at a point, going outwards, what distance can you reach?
Wow, does it take into consideration elevation?
It takes into consideration things like traffic. There's a lot of things that it does take. Elevation is not one of them at the moment.
Yeah, that'd be interesting, because it's like if that Pokemon is just in reach, but it's up a hill, I would love to know whether or not I could reach that Pokemon. Cool, so do I define these reachable, like the criteria by which something is reachable?
So you tell us the point that you want to start from, and then you tell us the criteria to create the isochrone, and we will generate that for you.
Very cool.
If you, say, have an electric vehicle, and you know that you have enough battery life left to get, let's say, 15 minutes, you tell us, where is the distance that I can get in 15 minutes from this point? Mm-hmm. And we will create that geometry for you.
Okay.
And we'll generate that.
So if I like, we know these little electric scooters that everyone's talking about, or bicycles, or anything that has any kind of constraint.
Yes.
Even walking or something like that.
You can do walking as well, yeah.
Very cool. Got a demo for me?
Yeah, so first I'll start in Postman just to show how it's generated in code,
okay,
and then I will
cool.
show you another demo.
Nice.
So for this one, I decided to show you a 10-minute isochrone.
Okay.
So you pass in the time budget in seconds, and so I did 6,000 seconds, which is 10 minutes, and I will just...
Does it default to driving and assume standard speed limits?
It does default to driving, but you can specify walking.
Okay, and this in this case here, since you gave it so little information, you gave it only times, I assume it knows I'm not going to speed.
Yeah, well, it's assuming that.
Okay, just check.
Safe driving. So I'll scroll down here, and you see the center that you passed was this latitude, longitude, and then it starts to give you your boundary. So it will give you all of the points that define the boundary of that isochrone.
I see, and that boundary is a polygon.
Mm-hmm. And so to actually visualize this, I'm going to show you a demo that we put together that actually uses a bunch of our services together. So we're kind of showing the ways that you would use this in a practical application. So in this application, what I'm going to do is I'm going to give you a starting destination and an ending destination. So let's start in Redmond. Let's go to Seattle today. First, I'm going to calculate the directions.
Okay.
So this is a simple routing call that we've done here.
Cool.
The other thing you see is you see those gas stations, those icons there?
Mm-hmm.
We did a search along route. So we're finding all of the gas stations that are along this route that you could get to quickly. And in our demo here, let's pretend we're in a car and we're starting to run out of gas. And so this is important. When I animate the trip, what you're going to start to see is we started searching for isochrones as we were driving.
So where am I driving from?
You're starting in the upper right corner.
Okay.
That's where Redmond is, and then you're going to end in the lower left.
Okay, cool.
So when I start to animate the trip, you will see three points where isochrones are generated because we did a check and we assume that your gas is starting to run out. So we do a 15-minute check, a 10-minute check, and a 5-minute check.
I see, and it's interesting that you're doing that. You didn't just generate the isochrone, that constraint check, when you started because things change.
Yes.
And I like to think about, you know, those progress bars that go up to 99% and they sit there at 99% forever because you don't really know until you're done.
Yeah.
So things change. Maybe you're stuck in traffic. Maybe you went uphill. Maybe someone, I don't know, took gas out of your tank, whatever. You can check as many times as you want.
Yeah.
And you're checking on the fives.
And traffic conditions change over time, too. Sometimes when we do this route, it suggests 90 instead of 520. And so you'll see different results with this.
Oh, interesting.
So let me go ahead and animate this.
All right, cool. Nice.
And we do our first check right about here. So that's where you can get within 15 minutes.
Oh, and then you did the search.
All the gas stations.
But that wasn't a search on route. That was a search within a polygon.
Yeah.
Ooh.
So that is an additional thing that we plugged
in
here.
This is the coolest demo so far you've brought me.
So we use a number of our APIs. We first used the calculate route.
Cool.
We did a find along route, so we found all of the gas stations. We created the isochrones. We got those back. Then within the isochrone, we pass that to a method called search within geometry. We had a different video to demonstrate this before.
Right.
But what we did is we passed the isochrone, we searched within that geometry, and we looked for gas stations, for points of interest.
That's so cool.
And then we drew that out so you can see exactly where you can get and the gas station options you have within that limited time frame.
Now, it's interesting also because you did the search along route and you put the gas stations in blue, which those gas stations didn't show up. They're different gas stations that showed up within the polygon because it was a different question. Like in this one here on the left, you can see gas stations that are farther north appeared. Mm-hmm. They're not necessarily on the route, but if you were in a jam and this one's closed, you could go and route up to there.
Yeah, and that takes into traffic conditions and can you get there? If mm-hmm. I got off the road at this point, could I get to that gas station? That's what this is telling you.
So I could do this with like a little electric car, like if I had like a Leaf or something that had like 50 miles, mm-hmm. like you said, like a really small thing. I could search and do electric chargers or whatever.
Yeah.
That's cool. How many different services do you think you used here?
Like we did routing, search along route, we did isochrones, and we did geometry search.
That's cool. Is this sample going to be made available? Because I feel like I need to have
this. Not yet, but I would like to make this publicly available.
If you would make this publicly available, I'd be very happy with that.
Yeah.
That's cool. So this is isochrones.
Mm-hmm.
And this is a known term. Like I'm literally learning this word for the very first time.
Yeah.
But GIS and mapping people are like, oh, Scott, everyone knows what an isochrone is.
Common term, but also considered reachable range. It's another way of referring to it.
Very cool. And this is all the things that are built into Azure Maps. I have this already. Once I've made my Azure Maps resource in the portal, I have my subscription key. Nothing here is outside of my abilities.
Yeah, it's all available today. Every single method that I called is all available today.
That's so cool. Well, thank you so much for sharing this with me.
Yeah.
All right, I'm learning all about reachable range and isochrones and Azure Maps today on Azure Friday.